Erica Mendez.
I don't know. There it is. Okay. I'm lazy, so I'm going to sit down. Sorry. Hi. I'm here. This is the first time I'm doing a convention in a mall, which is a little strange. But it's so cool to see so many of you here. This is really awesome. And all the cosplay. Like, I didn't expect this much when they told me it was a one-day event at a mall. So this is really cool. Thank you guys for coming out, whether you're here for me or for everything else that's going on, because there's a lot of cool stuff going on. So I'm going to take questions, if you guys have questions for me. So anytime you have a question, raise your hand, and we'll get you a mic so I can hear you, and I'll answer your questions. Anybody got a question? Yes.
Go ahead.
What was it like voicing Sailor Uranus? It's pretty crazy just because that show's like been around for so long, you know? I didn't watch it as a kid because I grew up in the Midwest and it would come on like right as I was getting home from school, so I couldn't catch up with it. And, you know, I was a kid, I didn't have money to buy like VHSs at the time. VHSs, geez, I'm that old. So I didn't watch too much of it until recently when the new dub came out, but I had always known about it. Like, I know so many people that knew about it. Even my mom knew about Sailor Moon. My mom knows nothing about anime. So, I was in a session for the show Love Live when I got the email saying that I'd gotten cast. And I was like, I couldn't tell anybody though, because they were really secretive about it. I mean, they're secretive about most things, but Sailor Moon was like, especially, they wanted to keep everything very tight-knit. So, I found out during the session and I had to try not to freak out in the middle of recording. So, yeah, it was really cool, and luckily for the Outer Guardians, we got to announce like maybe 2 weeks after we started recording, but I heard that the Inner Guardians had to wait like months before they finally could announce, so we got it a little bit easier, but yeah, we did like these big promotion things. I mean, we still do big promotion things at Anime Expo, and it's really cool to be part of something that's been around for so long and be a part of like this great new cast where we get to, you know, do all the relationships like as they should be in the Japanese. So yeah, it's been really cool, and a bunch of people tell me like they're like what Sailor Uranus and Sailor Neptune meant to them growing up, you know, in terms of like sexuality and stuff like that. So it's really cool. I love hearing people's stories.
But yeah, it's cool. I think a lot of people don't know that I voice cast.
Megan Nina Konosuba, Deanna and Seven Deadly Sins, and that's just a small gathering of stuff, but yeah, in case people didn't know. But okay, continue, sorry.
No worries.
There was a lot of pressure on that show. because I feel like Ryuko wouldn't fully trust him at first. But Gon would constantly be like, let's be friends. And she'd be like, I don't know. I gotta go find out who killed my dad, you know, and all that. But I think they'd make a pretty good team. So, but he'd be like a second Mako to her in a way, I think. But then she'd probably really bond with Killua. LA, I'm like, I don't like this, keep it away. But it is kind of cool having that gratitude. of being like, oh, look, I worked on a thing last week, and now it's coming out this week. That's really cool. Because otherwise, we have to wait, like, upwards of months to actually be able to announce even sometimes. But, yeah, so it's got its pros and cons, but for me, it's, like, mostly the con thing, just because of the production side. But, I mean, I'm really glad a lot of people are liking it since we're getting a really good response for Shield Hero. So, I mean, as long as people are liking it, I can't really, you know, knock on the process too much. But just personal preference, I would prefer not doing the same old style. Thank you, I appreciate that. Hi.
Hi. So I just gotta ask, because when I think of you, the first thing that always comes to my mind is Kill Kill. Okay. So I just gotta ask, what was the most difficult part of you doing that voice over Yuko?
For me, the most difficult part was being scared to like let go and kind of like I don't have very good like typical comedic timing. Like my comedic stuff usually comes from like dry humor. So whenever the director, Alex Tom David, wanted me to go bigger and like goofier, it was a little bit hard for me to like get past myself and actually be able to do it to the fullest at first. Like I'm getting a little bit better at it as time goes on. But at the time it was like really hard because I was like, no, I gotta be serious, I gotta do this right, you know. But so he had to push me a little bit to get past that stuff. But other than that, like just like I was kind of mentioning earlier, just the screaming aspect of it. Some of those screams are pretty like raw and dirty, you know, so some of those took a few too many tries to get them right, but I mean, I'm pretty happy with the result, so. Yeah. Hi, I like your bag.
So you play a metal vocalist on Everett's sequel?
Yes.
Do you like bands like that?
Do I like, actually, I don't do the death metal. Is that what you're asking?
But do you like, do you listen to bands like
that? I don't actually. But the show definitely has me interested in it. So the guy who does, so many people ask me, like, do you do the death metal? And I'm like, no, it's not me. It's like an actual man who does it. Because in the Japanese, they have a man singing it. So we did the same thing for the English version. And Jameson Boas, who does the singing, is like an actual heavy metal singer. So he knows what he's doing. But yeah, I listen to some of his stuff. And I haven't had the time to actually go and like find new bands to like actually listen to, but I'm definitely more interested in it than I've ever been in my life, so it was a cool style. Yeah, thank you.
Hi. I'd like to ask that you took a role in the Gundam Build Fires animation?
I did.
As well as the Garland movie?
Yes.
Yeah, I thought it was you.
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, what was it like taking those roles in the Gundam series as well as the animation of Garo? What was it like?
Gundam is always really fun. I was in Gundam Iron-Blooded Orphans as a smaller part, but being in Gundam Build Fighters was cool because I got to be a bigger part in it. I played Yuki in Gundam Build. Gundam Build Divers. But yeah, but that's okay. And Yuki is a really fun character to play. He's like the best friend character, and he's kind of like geeky, so I like playing those types of roles where I get to be a little bit, you know, a little bit less of the tough person and just kind of like, you know, normal, like, best friend, like, guy next door, girl next door kind of character, so that's always really fun. Because you don't have to scream, usually, which is really nice sometimes. But, and then Garo, I didn't do too much of Garo, but the movie, yeah, I was in the movie and the TV series, but yeah, but they're really fun. I got to be in those because of Caitlin.
So I wanted to ask you now, out of outside of anime, is there any big series or franchise you'd like to act in and be a part of one day?
If I could be in anything, I would love to be... There's a few things. I'd love to be like any superhero. Like, I've auditioned for Gwen Stacy once, and I'd love to be like a Gwen Stacy type or something like that. Or I love the Final Fantasy series, and I was just recently in... Chocobo Dungeon, which is probably the closest I've been so far, but I want to be in like a mainstay Final Fantasy game, and I'd love to be in Persona, but yeah. Thank you. Hello.
Hi. I teach digital media, and what advice would you give young people that are considering becoming voice actors?
What advice would you give people who want to be voice actors? Take acting classes, that's the first and foremost important thing. Voices, it's about like your acting ability, and because there are so many people that are like, oh, I can do an impression of like Homer Simpson, or I can do an impression of SpongeBob. It's like, well, those guys still exist, so it's good to be able to do impressions, but you want to be able to act and like be able to create your own versions of those characters, to kind of create new characters, if that makes sense. So basically you're like stealing from other people and making it your own in a way. So there's that. So acting classes, improv classes I hear are really good, so you can learn how to like do things on the fly. Because a lot of the times when we're acting for voiceover, they'll ask us to do like two or three different versions of the line. So you need to know on the fly how to be able to switch that up and make it a completely different read so that they have choices to pick from. Other things, just general rules, like be a good person. Being a good person is always really important just in life in general. And there's actually a website called iwanttobeavoiceactor.com, and that has a lot of good information on it. It's made by a man named D. Bradley Baker, who's been in the industry for like ever, longer than I've been alive maybe even, I don't know. And he has I think he updates it fairly frequently, but it's got like, you know, information about like classes and demos and what you need to do, like things you should look out for, how to take care of your voice and stuff like that. So I feel like any advice he has on that site is probably way more valuable than anything I could tell anybody. But definitely like the first thing is like acting. Just know how to act. And you know, if you're not taking any classes in school, like there's community theater. Know how to cold read, which means like just being able to open something and be able to read it and not sound like you're reading it. Making things conversational is important, because a lot of time, you know, you're not going to be able to hear that other person unless you're doing what's called an ensemble session where you're with other actors. But for anime and a lot of video games, we record alone, so you have to be able to make the conversation sound real without somebody else being there. So cold reading is very important for that. So big ways to practice that would be like reading books to kids. I think some libraries have things like that where you can read books to older people or for children. Read books for the blind, stuff like that. So yeah, there's plenty of options out there for practicing. And then also, what's really important is to move where the work is. Texas is definitely a good spot, but I go to some other states where it's like, you know, middle of nowhere, Iowa, and they're like, how do I become a voice actor? It's like, well, you have to move to a place where there is voice acting. And even if there isn't like a main industry for voiceover and wherever you're at, I'm sure there's always like local radio stations that may be interested in people. So just, yeah, just look for opportunities wherever you can. Thank you. Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm wondering to know with you how you feel about playing Emma in Women's Single Man.
Oh yeah, I was actually just thinking about that, like, because it's so new, I keep forgetting to mention that I'm Emma in Promise Neverland. And this is actually, Promise Neverland was super exciting to be a part of because when I moved, I'm originally from Chicago, and when I moved to Los Angeles, I actually sold my entire manga collection because I loved anime, you know, even before I started doing voiceover. So I sold my entire manga collection, and I haven't read a manga since, and that was like 8 years ago. I decided to pick up Promise Neverland before I was even in it and started reading it, and now I can't stop reading it, and I'm caught up, and I'm like, keep constantly refreshing the Shonen Jump page to try to find the new chapter when it comes out. That's how much I, like, love this series, and it's definitely, like, I love a lot of the series that I've been a part of, but this one definitely has me, like, hooked just in all aspects of it. I love the characters, even the bad ones. I just love the idea of it, like, where the manga's going. I'm excited for what's to come in the second season when that comes out next year. But playing Emma, it was actually kind of unexpected. I didn't think I was going to cast as Emma. I actually thought I was going to be one of the boys, because I'm so used to getting cast as boys. But being Emma has, like, made me grow to really appreciate her. And now every time I see something, like, that's a little bit compromising happen to her in the manga when I'm reading it, I, like, always want to cry, because I'm like, no, that's, like, my child. I don't want anything bad happening to her. So it's been really fun. It's a very challenging role, just because, I mean, you hear my voice naturally. It's not, it doesn't sound like a, you know, a young girl. But I have to, like, pitch it. Really, I can't do it right now, because, like, I mentioned earlier, my voice is a little shot, because I have, like, I don't know, allergies or something's going on with my throat. But I have to pitch it up pretty high to get that sound, you know? So it can be difficult, especially when we're doing longer recording sessions. But it's been really fun. So I really love the cast. And I also write the scripts for the anime. I do the adaptation to fit the mouth flaps and everything. So I have a lot of respect and input into the show. So it's been a really fun experience getting to work on it. Thank you. Hi, it's your turn.
to answer the allergy thing, it's Texas.
Yeah, well, it's like that in LA too.
Worst city in the planet for allergies. Go ahead.
Hello, oh my God, it's so amazing to meet you.
Thank you.
Yes. But other than trying to be good anime characters?
Well, like I kind of mentioned before, like I liked anime even before I knew what anime was. Like I used to watch Speed Racer and like Astro Boy with my dad and stuff like that. So I've always been interested in it. I didn't figure out what it was until I was like in middle school. So it's about like 12, 13 years old. And it really helped me. I didn't have very many friends then. So liking anime and finding the few people that did like anime, like I've made friends and I still know those people. And even now, like liking anime and doing voiceover, like I've met so many people in my life that have made such lasting impressions. And it's been really good for me, and it's made me a better person, I think. So I totally what you mean, like getting confidence from anime. So I think that's what I like about anime too, is that there are a lot of just inspirational, like underdog stories compared to like things you see in Western media, which is more like slapstick usually. Not to say that anime doesn't have that, but I just think the media of Japanese animation is just incredible with storytelling, and the characters are always so like really cool.
Aside from anime,